आई एम मिस्टर सर्वज्ञ गांधी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रिगार्डिंग रूल्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट रूट लोकस. एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द रूल्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट रूट लोकस एंड एनालाइज द नेचर ऑफ रूट लोकस. रूल्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट रूट लोकस. Rule 1. The root locus is always symmetric about real axis. The roots of the characteristic equation are either real or complex or combination of both. Therefore, their locus must be symmetric about the real axis of S-plane. The roots which are real can be plus or minus 2. The roots which are complex can be minus 1 plus 2j, and the roots which are complex conjugate can be minus 1 plus or minus 1j. Rule 2. So from this we can know the number of branches which are going to approach infinity. From the given open loop transfer function, that is g of s into h of s, we can find the number of zeros and number of poles. So whatever is present at the numerator, that represents zeros, and whatever is present at the denominator represents pole, and we need to count that number. So z represent number of open loop zeros, whereas p represent number of open loop poles. Generally the value of p is greater than z. So from this we are going to calculate the value of n, that is p minus z, that is going to represent number of branches which are going to approach infinity. Whatever may be the case, the branch direction always remain from open loop poles where the value of k is 0 towards open loop zeros where the k value tends to infinity. So if we try to draw the sketch of S plane which has real and imaginary part, so we can see that there are two roots, out of which at minus 1 we have pole and at minus 2 we have zero, and those are represented as cross and circles respectively. So now we can see that root locus moves from open loop pole to open loop zero, where the value of k varies from k is equal to 0 to k equal to infinity. So if we try to see the example of this pertaining to rule number 2, so we can see in first example of open loop transfer function as k divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. Now in this case the simplified form of the polynomial equation is given to us. So from that we can see number of zeros present are 0, whereas the number of poles present are 3. So if we try to calculate the number of branches which are going to approach infinity, so that will be 3 minus 0. So that implies 3 branches are going to approach infinity. So if we take the second case where we have open loop transfer function as k into s plus 2 into s plus 5 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 3 into s plus 4. So if we count the number of zeros, so it gives us 2. If we count the number of poles, so we have 4. So n represent number of branches which are approaching infinity, so that will be 4 minus 2. So it implies that 2 branches are going to approach infinity. So rule number 3. A point on a real axis lies on root locus if the sum of number of open loop poles and open loop zeros on the real axis to the right hand side of this point is odd. So whatever, so if we take a section in between the roots and if we try to see towards the right hand side of that section, if we are getting the count as odd, so we can say that in between those two roots the root locus is going to exist. So for example, open loop transfer function is given to us as k into s plus 1 into s plus 4 divided by s plus 3 into s plus 5. So if we try to draw the s plane for this, so we are going to have zeros which are at minus 1 and minus 4 which are represented by circle, whereas we are going to have the poles at minus 3 and minus 5 which are represented by cross. So we are going to see now where does root locus exist on this real axis. So if we try to take a section in between -1 and -3, at which the roots are existing, and if we see the right hand side of that section, so we can find the count to be 1, which is odd. So we can say that root locus exists between -1 and -3. Then we have the roots which are existing between -3 and -4. So if we try to take a section in between that and see how many roots are there on its right hand side, the count goes to 2. So it is even. So root locus will not exist between -3 and -4. Next, we have the roots at -4 and -5. If we count the number of roots which are on its right hand side, we get the count to be 3, which is odd. So root locus is going to exist between -4 and -5. Lastly, we have the root at -5, and if we take a section beyond -5 and observe how many roots are there on its right hand side, so we get the count to be 4, which is even. So root locus will not exist beyond point -5. So the root locus is existing between -1 and -3 and -4 and -5. So in this rule number 3, we have one note. While counting the number of roots which are on the right hand side of the section which is drawn by you, you are not supposed to count the complex conjugate roots. So for example, if the open loop transfer function is given to us as k into s plus 2 divided by s square into s square plus 2s plus 2 into s plus 3. So if you try to write the simplified version of the polynomial equation that is given to you in the denominator, then we can write it as k into s plus 2 divided by s square into s plus 1 plus j and s plus 1 minus j into s plus 3. So if you try to count the number of zeros which are present, so it comes to be 1, and it is going to lie at minus 2. Whereas the number of poles which are given in the open loop transfer function counts to 5, and the roots are going to lie at 0, 0, minus 1, minus j, minus 1, plus j, and minus 3. Correct? So we are going to draw it on S plane. Fine. So we can see that at origin we have 2 roots, whereas at minus 2 we have 1, and we have 2 roots which are complex conjugate at minus 1 plus or minus j. So if we try to take first section in between 0 and minus 1, so we have to count how many roots are there on the right hand side. So the count goes to be 4 by considering the complex conjugates. So if we don't consider that, the count goes to be 2. So 2 and 4 both are even. So there is no change in the nature by adding the complex conjugate. Correct? So root locus is not going to exist between 0 and minus 2. So if we take a section in between minus 2 and minus 3, without considering the complex conjugate, the count goes to 3, which is odd. And if we consider the complex conjugate, the count goes to 3 plus 2, that is 5, that is also odd. So we are going to have the root locus in between minus 2 and minus 3. So by counting the complex conjugate, there is going to be no difference in the nature. It is going to remain even if the condition is even. It is going to remain odd if the condition is odd. So if we try to take a section in between minus 3 and minus 4, the number of roots which are on the right hand side without considering the complex conjugate roots, the count goes to 4, which is even. So root locus will not exist between minus 3 and minus 4. In rule number 4, we are going to find the angle of asymptotes. So angle of asymptotes gives us the information that how many branches are approaching infinity. Generally, the number of poles are more than the number of zeros. So P minus Z branches are going to approach infinity. But how are these branches going to approach infinity? So for those branches which are approaching infinity, asymptotes will act as a guideline for them, so which is going to travel up to infinity. So angle of asymptote is represented as theta, which is equal to 2q plus 1 into 180 divided by p minus z. So in this, you need to vary the value of q, and for that the equation is p minus z minus 1. The value of q ranges from 0 1 to up to infinity. Rule number 5. So in this rule we are going to find the centroid. So that is the location of asymptotes on S plane. All the asymptotes intersect the real axis at a common point called as asymptotes, and that is represented by sigma. So the equation comes out to be summation of real part of pole of g of s h of s minus summation of real part of zeros of g of s into h of s divided by p minus z. So in this you need to note centroid is always real. It may be located on negative real axis or it can be located on positive real axis. It may or may not be a part of root locus. So we'll see one example for which we are going to apply all the 5 rules that we have studied. So open loop transfer function given to us is k divided by s plus 1 into s plus 2 plus 2j s plus 2 minus 2j. In step number 1, the number of zeros are 0, the number of poles are 3, which are at minus 1 minus 2 plus 2j minus 2 minus 2j, and n number of branches which are approaching infinity are 3 minus 0. So that implies 3 branches are going to approach infinity. Then angle of asymptotes, that is 2q plus 1 into 180 divided by p minus z. Since the value of p minus z is 3, we are going to select 3 values for q that are 0, 1 and 2 respectively. So we are going to get the angle of asymptotes as 60, 180 and 300. In step number 3, we are going to find the centroid, that is summation of real part of poles minus summation of real part of zeros divided by p minus z. So it comes out to be minus 5 by 3, that is minus 1.67. We can see the root locus exists between minus 1 up to infinity. The centroid is located as minus 1.67, and from that the asymptotes angle, which are 60, 180 and 300, are going to pass. And we are going to measure the angle in anticlockwise positively. These are my references. Thank you.